measuring thumb MP flexion. Your axis of your goniometer will be on the first MP joint here. Your movement arm will be on the proximal phalanx, and your stationary arm will run along the shaft of the first metacarpal. So I'll go like this. So Rachel, if you could flex down your thumb for me. So we're looking at 60 degrees flexion at this joint here. That's the normal ranges of motion for this joint in most people is about 0 to 50. But Rachel here has a little bit more than that. Rachel, now you can, if you could, flex your thumb down for me as far as you can go. So if you look here, this thumb is about 80 degrees of flexion at the MP joint. So that's a little bit more irregular, but it's just kind of neat to see that not all joints are similar. Measuring thumb MP extension. So just like flexion, you want your stationary arm to be on the first metacarpal, your axis on the MP joint, and your movement arm on the proximal phalanx. So Rachel, bring your thumb into extension for me. So as you can see here, if I was to measure this on top of the thumb, I would get a very inaccurate reading. I would get, you know, negative or plus 20 degrees of hyperextension at this joint. But as you can see, that's clearly not the case. At this MC joint itself, it's about 0 degrees. So if you want to flex, if you want to measure it, just angle it a little bit off the thumb. And here we can see 0 degrees of extension. Measuring thumb IP flexion. Have your stationary arm on the proximal phalanx, your movement arm on the distal phalanx with your axis on the IP joint itself. Rachel, what I want you to do is flex your thumb down for me as much as you can. There we go. And we are looking at a 75 degrees of flexion at this joint. Measuring thumb IP hyperextension. You want to have your stationary arm of your goniometer on the proximal phalanx, your movement arm on the distal phalanx, and your axis on the IP joint itself. So, like this. So Rachel, if you could, hyperextend that thumb backwards as far as you can go. There we go. So once again, right there. So we're looking at 40 degrees of hyperextension. Measuring thumb radial abduction, also known as CMC joint extension. To measure this joint, the most important thing to do is to find the true CMC joint. So to do that, Rachel, what I want you to do is I want you to move your thumb back and forth for me. Now, if you look here, you can see this joint is moving right here, right inside the anatomical snuff box. So what we're going to do is we're going to put our axis right on that location. Okay, and then the stationary arm, we're going to measure on the lateral aspect of the second metacarpal, so right here. And then the movement arm, we're going to line up with the shaft of the first metacarpal, right here. So Rachel, if you could, bring that thumb out for me as far as you can. Bring that out. And, here we go, that about right there. So we are looking at 50 degrees for this measurement, which is quite common. Measuring thumb palmar abduction, also known as CMC abduction. Once again, we want to find the true CMC joint. So Rachel, if you could move your thumb back and forth for me. So if you can see, the true joint of the CMC is right down here near the anatomical snuff box. So that's where we will place our axis. Our stationary arm, we're going to have on the lateral aspect of the second metacarpal, so right here, and then the movement arm we're gonna have on the shaft of the first metacarpal, like this. Oh, Max is a little off. Okay, so Rachel, if you could, extend your thumb out as far out as you can. And we're looking 46 degrees of abduction for this measurement. Measuring thumb opposition, patient will be in a seated position, elbow on table, hand in the air. The object of this measurement is to find the distance between the tips of the fingers and the tip of the thumb. So Rachel, if you could, touch all your fingers to your thumb for me. Very good. This would be seen as having no deficits. Now, Rachel, I want you to try that again, except pretend like you cannot touch the tip of your pinky to the tip of your thumb. Now, if you see this deficit, what you're going to do is you're going to grab your goniometer and you're going to measure this distance between these two fingers in millimeters or centimeters. Just whatever you do, make sure you're consistent. So I'm going to put right that right there, right here. And I'm looking at about 38 millimeters. And you want to do the same measurement for all of the fingers.